conservative America. And the Democratic Party was now the party of radical progressive leftists and hippies. Oh, and black church ladies. Right. About that. Black Christians are socially conservative. They're theologically conservative. So why aren't they politically conservative too? Black Christians and white Christians vote very differently, partly because their histories and life experiences are vastly different. When white Christians look at the Supreme Court, for example, they see the reason abortion is legal and school prayer isn't. But when black Christians look at the Supreme Court, they see the reason they can vote and pursue housing and employment without blatant discrimination. That difference in perspective has a huge impact on whether you see the federal government as part of the problem or part of the solution. Having the right to hear a Christian prayer in your local public school doesn't mean much if you're not allowed to attend your local public school. And think about the words progressive and conservative. A progressive believes things should be improved by making progress, by moving forward, by progressing. A conservative believes the good things we presently have are at risk of being lost and need to be conserved, or even revived from the past. So the best way to explain why white Christians vote for conservative candidates and black Christians vote for progressive candidates may simply be this. What do we see when we look in the rearview mirror? White Christians see a simpler time, when everyone went to church, when we prayed in school, when abortion was illegal and gender roles were clear. When black Christians look in the rearview mirror, the view is very different. They see fire hoses and church bombings and lynchings. They see Strom Thurmond saying, "We will never let Negroes into our theaters, swimming pools, homes, or churches." They see white Christians applauding Strom Thurmond for saying that, and then re-electing him to the Senate for 5 decades until he dies in office in 2003 at the age of 100. Is this beginning to make sense? There are other issues. Conservative white Christians see sin mostly as an individual problem, wrongs committed by one person against another, requiring only individual confession and repentance as the solution. Black Christians also see sin as a systemic problem, sinful systems needing broader solutions and broader confession and repentance. So to wrap all this up, it really doesn't help that we've only got 2 viable parties, and that we've decided one is for people who want things to change, and the other is for people who want things to stay the same. I'm oversimplifying, but you get the point. The Bible calls us to hold on to what is good, while also working toward what is best, to conserve and progress. And neither party lines up with that very well. But I hope at least now...